Usually whenever we think of sexuality, we think of four things: straight, gay, lesbian, and bisexual. But there are a lot more sexualities that really aren't talked about. So in today's video, I wanted to talk about different types of sexualities and help you guys to discover whether or not you belong to these labels or not. So stick around for this video. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be talking about different types of sexualities. For a lot of people, they don't know that these exist because they're not talked about in the mainstream. And for a lot of people, they're questioning their sexuality. Are they straight? Are they gay? Are they lesbian or bisexual? But they don't realize that there's so many different sexualities that exist that you might not belong to those four because you might be something completely different. So in today's video, I wanted to talk about those different sexualities. But if you're not subscribed to my channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell for videos every single week. I do make a lot of videos about my sexuality and my virginity. So if that's something you're into, be sure to subscribe. But we're just gonna hop right into this video and start talking about these different sexualities, so maybe when you leave this video you can know exactly what you are. And if you do find any information in this video helpful, please leave a comment and a like, because it really does help with the algorithm and supporting me, because we're trying to grow this community to 10,000 before the end of the year, and I think we can make it happen, but not without you. So the first one is asexual. There was a point in my life when I thought I was asexual because I'm still a virgin and I never really had that moment in life where I've kind of discovered my sex life. But I think the difference between me and someone who actually is asexual is an asexual person is someone who just doesn't feel a sexual attraction towards anyone. And for me, I feel sexual attraction. I know that I have those feelings, but for someone who's asexual, you don't feel that way. So whenever people bring up that conversation, they might feel a little awkward towards what those people are feeling. If you're a biromantic person, it means that you're romantically attracted to two or more genders. Just as a bisexual person is someone who is sexually attracted to two or more genders, someone who's only biromantic is someone who is only romantically attracted towards those genders. As you are asexual, there is aromantic, which is someone who doesn't have romantic attraction towards anyone. So someone who's asexual won't have that sexual attraction, but someone who's aromantic won't have that romantic attraction either. If you're heteroromantic, it means that you just have romantic attractions towards someone of the opposite gender. As well, if you're homoromantic, it means that you have romantic attractions towards, you guessed it, the same gender. Because we're all homos here, aren't we? Maybe not. Probably some straights here too, but it's okay. We love you the same. Someone who is antisexual is just someone who believes that sex is wrong or should be avoided in all cases. Someone who is gray sexual is someone who might feel sexual attraction at some times, but other times they feel no sexual attraction at all. It could also mean that they don't have a high sex drive. They might feel that attraction, but they don't feel the need to act on it. And it could also mean someone who enjoys sex, but only in certain situations. So if things are black and white, you are gray, which means that you kind of like it sometimes but don't like it others. Someone who is demisexual is someone who feels romantic and sexual attraction to someone, but only after they get to know them and really form that connection and that bond with them. If you're panromantic, it just means that you have a romantic attraction to people, not based on their gender. That's really a lot of the different sexualities that I wanted to talk about in this video. For me, I've definitely experienced and felt like I related to a lot of these different categories throughout my life. I also felt like I was asexual at one point, but I realized that I do have sexual attraction. So one thing that you kind of have to go through whenever trying to discover your sexuality is really taking the time to evaluate how you really feel. Sometimes we let other people dictate how we feel, or we kind of let other people's opinions get in our head. We might think that we're gay because our friend said,
"You're acting gay,"
and we don't exactly know what we are. But I think it's important that we really evaluate our feelings and how we're acting to really move forward with discovering our sexuality and understanding ourselves. And I know that this video wasn't really in depth into what these are. I'm learning them myself, but I do like to learn and I do like to understand things. So I hope you guys got a little bit out of this video. If you didn't, it's okay. You can leave hate. Please let me know your sexualities and explain to me how you're feeling. If I skipped any, please comment down below what they are, because I would love to learn and I would love to keep growing as an individual and really getting educated on things. I want to thank you guys for watching this video and subscribing to my channel. We are going to hit 10,000 by the end of the year. I feel it in my bones, but thank you guys again. Roger that.